Our word of the day. Our word of the day comes from Colossians chapter 1, verses 3 and 4. That's Colossians chapter 1, verses 3 and 4. And it says, "We give thanks to the Lord and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, praying always for you. Since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of your love for all the saints, praise the Lord for that." Once more. Since we give thanks to God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, praying always for you. Since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of your love for all the saints. Amen. Every morning we all gather here to pray and to give thanks to our Lord Jesus Christ. We share our testimonies. We petition all our loved ones and those that are sick and hurting and everything that's going on in our lives, this world even, we all come before the Lord. And that's what the Lord is always telling us to do. The greatest weapon that we have is prayer. We should always be praying. We should pray without ceasing. That's exactly what that means. Pray all the time. Pray for everything. Pray for one another. Because God wants us to just give it to him. God sees the love that we have for one another, and he sees the love that we have for others, because the two greatest commandments is to love God and to love people. We know we of ourselves cannot change our situation. We can't change anything that's going on with our friends and families and loved ones, not even in our own lives. But we know God is in control. And that's why the Lord always tells us to pray. Prayer changes everything. In Ephesians chapter 6, verse 18, it says, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. You know, God is truly telling us we need to continue to pray for our families and hold on to those prayers. Continue to pray for each other, because we're all family. We're all brothers and sisters in Christ. Continue to lift each other up. Continue to edify one another. Continue in prayer. Continue to petition the Lord. Entreat the Lord. Supplication is petition, making our requests known to him. Petitioning him. Because the times will grow hard. And things are going to get worse and worse. But the greatest power we have is truly prayer. So we are watchful. We see things unfolding in our families, in our lives, in the world. We need to just pray about it. God is truly never telling us to go out and fix anything. He tells us to pray and give it to him. Now, he may lead and guide us to do things, but that's different than just giving it to him and praying about it. We know that if we are led to do something, God is with us and he's going to take care of it. In Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, it says, "Be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God." You know, there's nothing really too small for God. There's nothing too small for God. Sometimes we say, well, we don't want to pray for the little things, but God wants us to pray for the little things. We reserve our prayers for the bigger stuff, for the bigger issues, for the bigger, but this word is saying, pray for everything. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything in prayer. Petition the Lord. Seek the Lord with thanksgiving, and let your requests be made known to him. So with this verse, it's saying, make all your requests be known to him. Everything. Everything that's troubling us, everything that we struggle with, everything that doesn't look right in our lives, everything that we truly can't do without the Lord. And that's everything. Nothing we can do without the Lord. So we have prayer. The world will try and fix their own problems and right their own wrongs and take care of the injustices of the world and do all of these things and try and fix it. And, and they haven't fixed anything yet because it just keeps getting worse and worse and worse. They just make it worse. But God wants us truly to know today that he hears our prayers. And he's telling us all to make our prayers be known to him. He already knows what they are anyway. But sometimes he just wants us to speak it. He wants us to cry out from our hearts. He wants us to share it ourselves. Amen to that. Mark 13:33, it says, take heed, watch, and pray. For you do not know when the time is. We always pray and we want God to answer us right at this moment that we pray. But we don't know the time that he's going to answer our prayers. Didn't say he wasn't going to answer them. We just don't know what time it is. So we pray and we watch and we wait. And in God's timing, he answers all our prayers. Every prayer on this list, God's going to answer one way or another. It's going to all be according to his will. But he's going to answer it in his due time. In Romans 1, verses 8 and 9, it says, first, I thank my God through Jesus Christ for you all, that your faith is spoken of throughout the whole world. For God is my witness, whom I serve with my spirit in the gospel of his Son, that without ceasing, I make mention of you always in my prayers. Praise the Lord. We are always praying for one another. And that's what God wants us to do. We are all witnesses of the Spirit of the Lord. We all truly understand that there is a living God and he loves us all very much. And he guides us and he protects us. We talk about him all the time. We acknowledge him. We bear witness to him. We come before him with thanksgiving and with prayer and supplication, making mention always in our prayers. Father, we thank you for this word. We thank you for just reminding us to just continue to pray to you, to make our requests known. You also tell us to pray for one another. Pray for each and every one of us. I lift up each and every one of us today. You know the struggles we have in our lives. You know the issues that's going on. You know everything. And I pray that we all just come before you and bow down and give it all to you, not trying to fix it ourselves, not trying to right the wrongs, not trying to handle our own issues, not trying to do it out, do it. Not trying to just do it. No. We are just supposed to just pray and wait. And in your time, and we know that you take care of everything. But I know that requires faith, and we all need to have the faith to do that. We all need to have the faith to trust in you. We all have to be have the faith to pray and wait for you to do it. We all have to have that. And we pray that you put that all in our hearts to just be watchful and to wait in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you all peace today. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. God bless you all and have a wonderful day in the Lord.